Welcome on part 4, the final part of the Oasis Mandala Call. We make round 1 up to round 19. In round 1 we start in a corner with a slip knot on the hook with the first color. Begin with a standing half double crochet in the point of a corner. Then make a chain 3. 1, 2, 3 and back in the same stitch with another half double crochet for the first corner. Here in this point we make 14 rows. In each row we make 1 half double crochet. Not here, but in this stitch here, that's the next row, that's the point where we go in with the hook and make a half double crochet. Go to the next row, and this point here, and half double crochet. Then into the next row, 14 in total. In each row, 1 half double crochet. That's 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and one more, 14. And we're going to make single crochets in the next 32 stitches. This is the first stitch, under through that V stitch, and make a single crochet. Into the next stitch, a single crochet. Go so on till you have 32 single crochets in total. After the single crochets we make in the next 14 rows of the next corner, in each stitch a half double crochet. This is the first, half double crochet, and then into the next row. And 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and one stitch here, it's number 14. And now you're on the point, you make a new corner of 1/2 double crochet, chain 3, and 1/2 double crochet into the same stitch. This corner is the same than the first corner. Repeat all these stitches all the way around. And then on the end of this round we make a slip stitch into the first standing half double crochet. Don't cut the yarn. In the next round we use the same color. Now we have in total all the way around 248 stitches. With the same color we begin with a chain 1, and this stitch is only to high up a stitch. We skip over to the chain 3 corner space and make a single crochet in that space, and chain 3, and back in that same space with another single crochet. And this is a new corner. Now make around each stitch and back post single crochet all the way up to the other corner. The first stitch here after the chain 3 space, go around that stitch from back to the front, from the front to the back, grab your yarn, and then pull through, yarn over, pull through 2. Go around the next stitch and back post single crochet, and around the next. Work so all the stitches to the next corner. My last stitches for the next corner. One more to go. And then we make a new corner in that chain 3 space. A single crochet, chain 3, and a single crochet in that same space. And now around every stitch and back post single crochet. I made my last stitches. I'm all the way around. And then here for the corner, we have one stitch to go. This stitch here. We make also a back post single crochet around that stitch. Now we cut the yarn and make an invisible join. We skip the first stitch, that's that single crochet in the corner. Go to the first chain stitch. Then back to the last stitch, only in the back loop. make a slip knot on the hook and we begin in a corner chain 3 space with a standing double crochet. Then in chain 3 and back in that same chain 3 corner space with another double crochet for a new corner. Now we work all the way around in each stitch 1 double crochet and work in the previous round. Be sure that you work not in that stitch on the front. Do not like this, but here in the back. In every stitch, 1 double crochet to the next corner. I'm almost in the next corner. 3 more stitches to go. And then into the next chain 3 space, a new corner. And double crochet in that space. And chain 3. 1, 2 and 3. And then a double crochet into the same chain 3 corner space. And then in every stitch, a double crochet. Work so all the way around and in the beginning we make an invisible join to close this round. Now we have 264 stitches in total. We begin with a slip knot on the hook and a standing single crochet in the chain 3 corner space. A chain 3. And then into the same corner space a single crochet. Now we work on every stitch 1 single crochet all the way around. And then in every corner a single crochet, chain 3, single crochet all the way around and then in the beginning we make this round complete with an invisible join. Not in that first standing single crochet but in the first chain stitch here. We begin with a new color with a standing single crochet in a corner space and chain 3 and a single crochet into the same corner space Now we work on the next 4 stitches, 1 single crochet. That's 1, 2, 3, and 4. And then in front post 3 double crochet around a stitch of round 21. That's that stitch here. Around this stitch here, that little stitch. Yarn 3 times over the hook. That's 1, 2, and 3. Now go to round 21, around that stitch. Yarn over, pull through. Yarn over, pull through 2. Yarn over, pull through 2. Yarn over, pull through 2. And yarn over, pull through 2. Now we skip 1 stitch. Go to the next stitch and make a single crochet. And also in the next 3 stitches, 1 single crochet. And then again, in front post 3 double crochet around a stitch below in round 21. Around that stitch and make a front post 3 double crochet. It's 1, 2, 3, and 4 times. And here in round 21, you see that we skip 5 stitches. We skip 1 stitch on the back, and then in the next 4 stitches, 1 single crochet. And we make again a front post 3 double crochet around a stitch of round 21. Then we skip the next stitch. And then in the next 4 stitches, 1 single crochet. And that's the way how we work all the way around. And I see you in the next corner. I'm almost in the next corner. I make my last front post 3 double crochet for the corner. Then we skip 1 stitch and we make in the last 3 stitches 1 single crochet. You see that we here make 3 single crochets, but we start with 4 single crochets. Now into the next corner. We make in that chain 3 corner space a single crochet, a chain 3, and a single crochet. And now we start all over again. You begin in the first 4 stitches, 1 single crochet. And a front post 3 double crochet around the stitch of round 21. Then we skip 1 stitch. And into the next 4 stitches, a single crochet. Work all the way around, and then in the beginning, we make on the top of that first standing single crochet a slip stitch. I made my last front post 3 double crochet. Skip 1 stitch and then in the last 3 stitches 1 single crochet. and we make on the top of that first standing single crochet a slip stitch. In the next round we use the same color. With the same color, we begin with a chain 1, and then back in that same stitch, we make a single crochet. Now in the chain 3 corner space, we make a new corner of 1 single crochet in that space, and chain 3, and a single crochet in that same space. Into the next 5 stitches. We work a single crochet. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And now we make a front post double crochet around that front post 3 double crochet of the previous round. And then into the next 4 stitches, 1 single crochet. It's 1, 2, 3, and 4. And we make again a front post double crochet. And 4 single crochets. Work so all the way around. For the next corner we make a single crochet in the last 4 stitches and then a new corner of 1 single crochet, chain 3 and 1 single crochet in that corner stitch. All the way around, and in the beginning we close this round with an invisible join, not in that first but in the second stitch. I made my stitches all the way around. My last front post double crochet. And then we have 3 stitches over. And in all those 3 stitches we make 1 single crochet. And we make an invisible join in the beginning. Here's the chain stitch, we skip that stitch and then also that first single crochet here. We go to the next stitch, back to the last stitch, only in the back loop. In the next round we use 2 colors, color 83 and color 86. We start with color 86. Make a slip knot on the hook. We begin with a standing single crochet in a corner chain 3 space, then a chain 3, back in that same corner with a single crochet. Now we work in the next 6 stitches 1 single crochet. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and by number 6 we change from color. 2 loops on the hook, change from color, grab your yarn and pull through. Now on the stitch of that front post double crochet, we work a cluster of 5 double crochets together. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, yarn over and work together. Now we change from color. Grab your new color and make a chain. Now into the next 4 stitches and single crochet, and we work also on the tails here. That's 1, 2, 3, and we change from color. Number 4. And now into the next stitch, that's on the stitch of the front post, double crochet and cluster of 5 double crochets together. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and work together. Change from color and make a chain. Into the next 4 stitches, 1 single crochet. It's 1, 2, 3, and the 4th stitch, we change from color. And we make on the front post double crochet, 5 double crochets together. That's number 5, yarn over and work together, change from color and make a chain 1. Into the next 4 stitches, a single crochet. And by number 4, we change from color. Repeat so all these stitches and I'll see you in the next corner. I made my last cluster of 5 double crochets. In the next 5 stitches, a single crochet. And then we make in the next corner space 1 single crochet and chain 3 and 1 single crochet. And this is the same corner than the first corner. Now we repeat all these stitches. We work in every stitch a single crochet. And on every top of a front post double crochet of the previous round, we work a cluster of 5 double crochets together. After the last cluster, we change from color and work in the next 5 stitches a single crochet. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, and the last stitch, that's number 5. Now we close this round on the top of that first standing single crochet with a slip stitch. In the next round we use the same color. and we cut off that color 83. With color 86, we start with a chain tool. Counts for nothing, it's only to high up that stitch. Into that same stitch, we make a double crochet. And now in that chain 3 corner space, one double crochet, chain 3, and a double crochet in that same corner space. And now we make an every stitch all the way around and double crochet. That first stitch is here after that chain 3 space. And a double crochet here for the cluster. Then on the top of the cluster, and in the next 4 stitches, also a double crochet. For the cluster, on the top of the cluster, work so all the way around, and then in every corner we make in that chain 3 corner space and double crochet, chain 3, double crochet in that same space. Then on every stitch and on the top of every cluster and double crochet, and then in the beginning we make an invisible join. Skip the chain 2 and the first double crochet. And then on the second double crochet here, you make that invisible join. We begin with a standing double crochet in that chain 3 corner space. Then a chain 3 and a double crochet in that same space. Make a chain 1 and then we skip the next 3 stitches, and then in the next stitch we make a V-stitch. 1 double crochet, chain 1 and 1 double crochet in that same stitch. That's a V-stitch. And chain 1. Skip the next 3 stitches and in the next stitch a new V-stitch of 1 double crochet, chain 1, 1 double crochet in that same stitch and a chain. Skip the next 3 stitches and double crochet, chain 1, double crochet in that same stitch and a chain. Skip 3 stitches and a new V-stitch. And a chain. Repeat all these stitches to the next corner. I work my last V-stitch for a corner, a chain, skip the next 3 stitches, and then on the last stitch for that chain 3 corner space, we make only 1 double crochet. In that chain 3 space, we make a new corner of a double crochet, chain 3, and a double crochet in that same space. Now we start all over again. We make a chain, skip 3 stitches, and in the next stitch, a V-stitch of 1 double crochet, chain 1, 1 double crochet in that same stitch, and a chain. Work so to the end, all the way around, and we make an invisible join here in the beginning on the second stitch. I'm all the way around, I make a chain, skip the next 3 stitches, and then only a double crochet in the last stitch. Now cut the yarn. Make an invisible join, not in the first, but in the second stitch. A new color. We begin with a standing double crochet in the first double crochet here for the corner. Make a chain and then skip over to the corner space. 3 double crochets together in that space. That's 1, 2, 3. And then yarn over, work together, make a chain 3, 1, 2, and 3, and a cluster of 3 double crochets together in that same corner space. That's 1, 2, 3, yarn over, work together. Make a chain 1, and then on the next stitch, on the double crochet here, we work a new double crochet. We make a chain 1. We skip over to the first V-stitch and work 3 double crochets together in that stitch. That's 1, 2, 3, work together. Make 1 chain, back in that same stitch, in that same V-stitch, a cluster of 3 double crochets together. Make a chain, skip over to the next V-stitch, and make a cluster of 3 double crochets together in that stitch. Chain 1 and a cluster of 3 double crochets in that same V-stitch. And 1 chain. And this is the repeat, we work all the way around. And see you here in the next corner. I've worked all the stitches on this side. Make a chain one and then a double crochet on the double crochet here for the corner. Chain one, we skip over to the corner space, a cluster of three double crochets in that space. Work together, make a chain three, and a cluster of three double crochets here in that same corner space. Make a chain one, and then in the next double crochet here on the top, you work a new double crochet, and chain one, skip over to the first V-stitch after the corner, make a cluster of three double crochets together. Chain one and a cluster of three double crochets into that same V-stitch. And a chain. Work so all the way around, and in the beginning we make an invisible join. Not in that double crochet, but here in that chain stitch. Start with a standing double crochet in a chain three corner space. Chain three and back in that same corner space with another double crochet. Into the next stitch we make a double crochet on the top of that first cluster. Now we skip one chain stitch here. Go to the next double crochet on the top of that double crochet, a new double crochet. And now we work in every stitch and in every chain one space, one double crochet. Into that chain one space, double, and a double on the top of the next cluster. And a double in the chain one space. And a double on the next cluster. And in the chain one space. Work so all the way up to the next corner. Double crochet here in the chain one, then a double crochet here on the top of that double crochet. I'm almost in the corner, on the cluster here of the corner, also a double crochet, and now in that chain three space, a double crochet, chain three, and a double crochet in that same chain three space. And now we begin from the beginning. On the top of the cluster, a double crochet. Now we skip this chain stitch after the cluster in the corner, and we make a double crochet on the double crochet, and double in the chain one, and on the top of the cluster. You skip one stitch here after every corner. This is the cluster, make a double crochet, and then we skip the next chain one space here. And we go to the next stitch and work a double crochet. Work so all the way around, and then we make an invisible join in the beginning on the second stitch. Now we have all the way around 320 stitches. New colors on the hook, and we begin with a standing double crochet in a chain 3 corner space. And chain 3. And back in that same space with another double crochet. And now in every stitch we make a double crochet. Work so all the way around, in every stitch a double crochet, and in every corner space a double crochet, chain 3, double crochet. And in the beginning, you work on the second stitch an invisible join. We have now all the way around in total 328 stitches. We start with a standing double crochet in a 3 chain corner space. And chain 3. And back in that same corner space with another double crochet. In the next stitch we make a double crochet. And chain 1, we skip the next 3 stitches, 1, 2 and 3, and then in the next stitch we make a V stitch, a double crochet, chain 1, double crochet in that same stitch. That's a V stitch. And chain 1, skip the next 3 stitches, into the next stitch, a V stitch of 1 double crochet, chain 1, 1 double crochet in that same stitch. And a chain. Skip 3 stitches, a V stitch in the next stitch, double crochet, chain, double crochet, and then a chain. Work all these stitches to the next corner. I'm almost in the next corner. I make my last V stitch, a chain, skip 3 stitches. Then we make in the next 2 stitches 1 double crochet. It's not a V stitch, but 2 times a double crochet. Like this. Now we skip over to the next corner. In that corner we make a double crochet, chain 3, and a double crochet in that same space. And then into the next stitch and double crochet. You see, for the corner we have 2 double crochets and after the corner 1 double crochet. Make a chain 1, skip 3 stitches and make a V stitch. And a chain. Work so all the way around, and in the beginning we make an invisible join. I'm almost on the end of this round, the last V stitch. Make a chain, skip the next 3 stitches, and then in the last 2 stitches for the first corner we make 2 double crochets. And we cut the yarn, open up that stitch, and we make an invisible join in the beginning, not on the top of that first standing double crochet, but in the first chain stitch. Begin with a standing 2 double crochet together in a corner space. That's 1. And 2, and work together. Then in chain 3 and back in that corner with 2 double crochets together. That's 1. And 2, yarn over, work together. And chain 1. Now we skip the next stitch. That's the first double crochet here, and then in the next stitch we make a double crochet. Make a chain 1. Now we skip over to the V stitch. And in that V stitch we make a 2 double crochet together. Then in chain 2, 1 and 2, and back in that same V stitch with another 2 double crochets together. That's 1 and 2, and work together. And chain 1, skip over to the next V stitch and make in that V stitch 2 double crochets together. Chain 2, 2 double crochets together in that same V stitch. And then in chain 1. Repeat all these stitches to the next corner. For the next corner, I make here my last group and chain 1, and then into the next 2 stitches 1 double crochet. That's 1, into the next stitch and 2, make a chain 1, we skip that last stitch here, and then in the corner we make a new corner 2 double crochets together. Chain 3 and 2 double crochets together in that same space. And chain, skip the next stitch, and in the next stitch you make a double crochet. And then we start all over again. Make a chain 1, skip over to the next V stitch and make in that V stitch 2 double crochets together. Chain 2 and 2 double crochets together in that same V stitch. And chain. Work so all the way around. Make all your stitches, and then on the end, before we close this round, we make in the last V stitch 2 groups of 2 double crochets together. Then we make the last 2 double crochets on the top of the double crochet here and chain, and then we close with an invisible join, not on the top of the first stitch but on the second, and that's the first chain stitch here. We begin with a standing single crochet in the corner space and chain 3 and a single crochet in that same space. Now we work in every stitch a single crochet and also in every chain 1 space a single crochet. On the stitch a single crochet and in the chain 1 a single crochet in the stitch and in the chain 1. I'm almost in the next corner. And in that chain 3 corner space, we make a single crochet, chain 3, and a single crochet in that same space. Repeat all these stitches all the way around and in the beginning we make an invisible join. On the second stitch. We start with a standing single crochet in the corner and chain 3 and a single crochet back in that same corner space for a new corner. And now we make all the way around in every stitch 1 single crochet. Make so all your stitches and then in every corner you make in that corner 3 chain space a new corner of 1 single crochet and chain 3 and 1 single crochet and then in every stitch 1 single crochet. In the beginning we close this round with a slip stitch on the top of that first standing single crochet. I'm all the way around my last single crochets and now in the first standing single crochet we close this round with a slip stitch. In the next round we use the same color. With the same color. We begin with a chain, count for nothing, only to high up a stitch. Now we go further into the next corner space with a single crochet, chain 3 and a single crochet into the same corner space. Now we work all the way around every stitch and back post single crochet. Go around that stitch, then on the back, grab your yarn, pull through, yarn over, pull through 2. From back post, single crochet, around the next stitch, grab your yarn and make a single crochet. Around the next stitch, around every stitch, all the way around, and back post, single crochet. work so all the stitches, and then in every corner we make a new corner of one single crochet and chain three, and one single crochet in that same chain three corner space. In the beginning we make an invisible join to close this round, and to show you how we do that. I'm almost on the end of this round, but I have just enough yarn. It's a little piece over from the bowl. If you run out of yarn at the end of this round, then pull out this round 17 and don't make this round. Skip round 17 and just make rounds 18 and 19. I make my last back post single crochets of this round. I'm almost on the last corner. And then around the last stitch here in the beginning, also a back post single crochet in that corner. Cut the yarn, but I don't have to do this. And then with the needle we make an invisible join. We skip the first stitch, that's that single crochet here in the corner, and then on the second stitch, under through that first chain stitch, we make that invisible join. Go to the last stitch, only in the back loop, and weave that tail in. We make in that corner space a standing single crochet and chain three, and into that same corner space a single crochet, and then in every stitch we make a single crochet. On these stitches here, on to a V stitch, and every stitch one single crochet. Then in every corner we make a new corner of one single crochet and chain three, and one single crochet, and then in every stitch one single crochet. In the stitches of the back post single crochets of the previous round, all the way around, and then in the beginning we close this round with a slip stitch. My last stitches for the corner. And then we close this round on the top of that first standing single crochet with a slip stitch. In the next round we use the same color. The final round with the same color and chain. Then in the corner space, one single crochet, and chain three, and a single crochet in that same corner space. Now we work around every stitch and back post single crochet. Around that stitch, on the back, and single crochet. Around the next stitch. Around every stitch to the next corner and back post single crochet. I'm almost in the next corner. The last stitch here for the chain 3 space. And now in that chain 3 we make a single crochet, a chain 3 and a single crochet in that same corner space. And then around every stitch and back post single crochet. So all the way around, and then in the beginning we make our last invisible join of this blanket, and then we're done. One more stitch for the corner, and we go around two stitches here in the beginning. Make a back post single crochet. And then we cut the yarn and make our last invisible join. Skip the first stitch, go to the next stitch, and that's that first chain of the chain 3 in the corner. Back to the last stitch, only in the back loop. And weave both ends in on the back of your blanket. You can see that your blanket is now curling up on the outside. Stretch the blanket again with needles and water as we did in part 2 and let it dry. And this is the end result. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and please thumbs up under my videos. Click on the bell so you don't miss any of my new upload tutorials. You can find me also on Facebook and Instagram en mijn website biancascrochetpalace.com. Here's a suggestion for another video. I hope you like it. Thank you for watching. See you next time. Bye!